Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss about asymptotes. Now let us consider the function y is equal to 1 upon x. Let us see its graph. We see that there are two curves in its graph. One lies in first quadrant and the other in third quadrant. Now we see that the branches of these curves are becoming closer and closer to y-axis, but they never intersect or cross y-axis. It means that y-values of the function approach to plus infinity and minus infinity as x approaches to 0 . So we say that y-axis is the asymptote of the given function . So we define asymptotes as an asymptote is a straight line which acts as a boundary for the graph of the function. When a function has an asymptote, the output values, that is y values of the function, get closer and closer to the asymptote as the input values, that is the x values, approach to either a specific value or positive or negative infinity. The functions most likely to have asymptotes are the rational functions. We will discuss three types of asymptotes, and these are vertical asymptote, horizontal asymptote and slant asymptote. First of all, we shall discuss vertical asymptote. Now in the graph of the function y is equal to 1 by x, y-axis is a straight vertical line and it is the vertical asymptote of this function, and its equation is given by x is equal to 0. See, as x approaches to 0 from right, the value of f of x or y increases without bounds towards plus infinity, and as x approaches to 0 from left, the value of f of x decreases without bound towards minus infinity. So we define the line x is equal to c is the vertical asymptote for a function f of x if f of x tends to plus infinity or f of x tends to minus infinity as x tends to c from either the left or from the right. Now we see how to find vertical asymptote algebraically. Let us consider the rational function f of x is equal to p of x upon q of x. The vertical asymptotes are found by equating the denominator of the function equal to 0 and solving it for x. That is, we put q of x is equal to 0 and solve it for x. The obtained values of x will give the vertical asymptote. For example, in the function f of x is equal to 1 by x, we know that it is a rational function. Where q of x is equal to x, so we put q of x is equal to 0, which implies that x is equal to 0. So here value of x is 0. So vertical line is drawn at x is equal to 0, which is the vertical asymptote of the function. Now we are going to discuss horizontal asymptote. Again see the graph of y is equal to 1 by x. See, in first quadrant, as the value of x increases or approaches to infinity, the value of y becomes smaller and smaller and approaches to 0. Similarly, in third quadrant, as x approaches to minus infinity, y approaches to 0. So these branches of the curve become closer and closer to x-axis but do not intersect or cross x-axis. Thus, here x-axis is the horizontal asymptote. Whose equation is y is equal to 0. Thus we define the line y is equal to d is the horizontal asymptote. For a function f of x, if f of x tends to d, as x tends to plus infinity or x tends to minus infinity. Now let us see method of determining horizontal asymptote algebraically. In a rational function, f of x is equal to p of x upon q of x, we determine the horizontal asymptotes by looking at the degree of both numerator and the denominator of the given function. If degree of numerator is less than degree of denominator, then the horizontal asymptote is always the line y is equal to 0. For example, in the function y is equal to 1 by x, the degree of numerator is 0. And degree of denominator is 1. Here we see that the degree of numerator is less than the degree of denominator. So here, horizontal asymptote will be equal to the line y is equal to 0. If degree of numerator is equal to degree of denominator, then the horizontal asymptote is obtained by dividing the leading coefficient of the numerator by the leading coefficient of the denominator. For example, in function y is equal to 5x square minus 3x plus 1 whole upon 2x square plus 5, the degree of both numerator and denominator is 2. Leading coefficient is the coefficient of the highest power of x. So, in the numerator, the leading coefficient is 5 and it is 2 in denominator. So, horizontal asymptote will be given by y is equal to 5 upon 2. So, on the graph, we will draw horizontal line at y is equal to 5 upon 2. Also, we should note that if degree of numerator is greater than degree of denominator, then we get a slant line as the asymptote and it is called slant asymptote. Now, let us see the method how to determine equation of slant asymptote. To find the equation of slant asymptote, we divide numerator by denominator of the given function using long division. Now let us consider the function y is equal to x square minus 3 whole upon x plus 1. Here, degree of numerator is greater than degree of denominator. We see that here degree of numerator is 2 and degree of denominator is 1 and 2 is greater than 1. So we say that degree of numerator is greater than degree of denominator. So using long division, we divide numerator by denominator. And we get now here x into x is x square plus 1 into x is plus x. On solving we get minus of x minus 3. Now again we multiply x by minus 1 and we get minus x plus 1 into minus 1 is minus 1 and on solving further we get minus 3 plus 1 that is minus 2. So here the quotient is x minus 1, which is the required asymptote. And therefore we say that the equation of slant asymptote is given by y is equal to x minus 1. Here we have seen we can write x square minus 3 as x minus 1 the whole into x plus 1 the whole minus 2, because we can write dividend is equal to quotient into divisor plus remainder. Now dividing both sides by x plus 1 the whole, we get x square minus 3 the whole upon x plus 1, which is equal to x minus 1 the whole into x plus 1 the whole upon x plus 1 minus 2 upon x plus 1, which implies that x square minus 3 the whole upon x plus 1 is equal to x minus 1 the whole minus 2 upon x plus 1. Now, when x approaches to infinity, then 2 upon x plus 1 approaches to 0. So, we are left with x square minus 3 the whole upon x plus 1 is equal to x minus 1. Now, this is the given function and it can be written as y is equal to x minus 1. So, now we will draw the line y is equal to x minus 1 as the asymptote of the given function. Now, this is the graph of the function y is equal to x square minus 3 whole upon x plus 1. This slant line shows the asymptote of this function, which is given by the equation y is equal to x minus 1. Now see, the branches of the curve are becoming closer and closer to the straight line y is equal to x minus 1. Thus, in this session we have discussed about asymptote and its types. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.